evening. This is All India Radio Kohima. I'm Jonas Yantan with the evening news. The headlines. Prime Minister Narendra Modi launches world's largest COVID-19 vaccination drive in the country. Chief Minister Nipiro launches state-level program of COVID-19 vaccination at Naga Hospital Authority, Kohima. NPCC General Secretary Reverend Dr. Zelho Geho expresses confidence that COVID-19 vaccine will bring protection to the community. And Center notifies 3,566 posts in central government suitable for persons with disabilities. Prime Minister Narendra Modi today said India's COVID-19 vaccination campaign is based on very humane principles and those exposed to maximum risk get priority. Launching the world's largest COVID-19 vaccination program through video conferencing, Modi stressed that this type of large-scale vaccination campaign has never before been run in the history. He pointed out that India is vaccinating 3 crore people in its first phase of vaccination. Modi added that in the second phase, 30 crore people will be vaccinated. He praised those scientists who had been involved in making the vaccine against corona for the past several months. He said India's fight against COVID-19 has been one of self-confidence and self-reliance. Modi said the whole world is today accepting the manner in which India has dealt with the pandemic. Prime Minister Modi said India also set the example in front of the world how centre and state governments, local bodies and social institutions can work better by uniting. Nagaland joined the rest of the nation in launching the world's largest COVID-19 vaccination drive today. Chief Minister Nipiro officially launched the state-level program at Naga Hospital Authority Kohima. The vaccination was launched in 9 sites, wherein 100 beneficiaries received the vaccines. Consultant and in charge of Critical Care Department, NHAK, Dr. Sentimeren Aunog, was the first recipient of the vaccine from Kohima District. Speaking at the launching program, Chief Minister Nipiro said health workers rightly deserve to be the first privileged people to be vaccinated. He expressed happiness that our country could make Made in India vaccine for all and also been able to export to the neighbouring countries. Rio said the vaccine, which has been approved by the Drug Controller General of India, is safe and found to be 70% efficient from the clinical test with good level of immunogenicity and antibodies. The Chief Minister urged upon all to come forward and register themselves for the vaccination so that all are safe and protected from the virus. Rio further expressed hope that it will be the beginning of restoring communities to wholeness and health as state joined the country in the world's largest vaccination program. In Dimapur District, Health and Family Welfare Minister S. Pangyopom launched a vaccination drive at Dimapur District Hospital. Pathologist from Dimapur District Hospital, Dr. Demser, received the first dose of Covishield vaccine in the district. Health Minister urged upon all beneficiaries to strictly maintain all COVID-19 appropriate behaviours during and after the vaccination. COVID-19 vaccination drive was held in all the 9 districts of Nagaland. In Jaluki, Minister for Higher Education and Tribal Affairs, Temchin Imnalong, graced the launching program of the vaccination. Additional Deputy Commissioner Mukukchung Shashank Singh launched COVID-19 vaccination for healthcare workers at Mukukchung in the presence of World Health Organization representative Dr. Satya Paas Karan at Imkong Lipa Memorial District Hospital. At Wokhout, the district task force administered 100 healthcare workers on COVID-19 vaccination launched by Deputy Commissioner and Chairman District Task Force for COVID-19 Orentang Lotha at Dr. Motso Memorial District Hospital. Meanwhile, Deputy Commissioner Zunoputo Peter Lichamo launched COVID-19 vaccination at the town hall. Advisor Powang Konyak launched the COVID-19 vaccination for Mon District. In Twensang, the vaccination drive was held at the district hospital, while at Longling, Deputy Commissioner M. Shayungpon launched the vaccination drive. As the country introduced the biggest vaccination drive against COVID-19, we present quick facts one should know about COVID-19 vaccination. On getting 2 doses of COVID-19 vaccine, the beneficiary will receive SMS on their mobile number. After all doses of vaccine are administered, a QR code-based certificate will also be sent on their number. This news comes to you from All India Radio, Kohima. Nagaland Baptist Church Council, NBCC General Secretary Reverend Dr. Zelho Geho said one needs God's wisdom to discern right from wrong. He opined that due to our inability to distinguish between right and wrong, people are easily swayed away and get confused. Reverend Geho said people may have doubts and apprehensions in the efficacy of the COVID-19 vaccine. He, however, said one need to leave that to the experts. Expounding on a revelation about the vaccine being circulated in the social media, asking the believers not to receive the vaccine, he said, "We do not condemn anyone, nor do we endorse everything they say." Reverend Geho said, "Our role is to pray that God will use the vaccine to bring protection to the community." The NBCC General Secretary appealed all to continue to pray for those who are affected and sick and for families who have lost their loved ones to the pandemic. Department of Empowerment of Persons with Disabilities has notified 3,566 posts in central government establishments as suitable for persons with benchmark disabilities under the Rights of Persons with Disabilities Act 2016. Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment in a statement said that these posts include 1,046 in Group A, 515 in Group B, 1,724 in Group C, and 281 in Group D posts. Posts have also been identified suitable for new categories of persons with disabilities, such as dwarfism, acidotic victims, muscular dystrophy, autism, spectrum disorder, intellectual disability, specific learning disability, mental illness, and multiple disability have been added. This list is not an exhaustive one, and central ministries, departments, autonomous bodies, and public sector undertakings may further supplement. This notification will broaden scope for employment for persons with benchmark disabilities in government establishments. Nagaland reported 15 positive cases of COVID-19 today, taking the total tally to 12,054. Health and Family Welfare Minister S. Pongyapom in a tweet said 11 cases were detected from Kohima, 3 in Mokokchung and 1 from Dimapur. Besides, one patient, each from Mokokchung and Longleng, has recovered from the infection. So far, 11,709 have recovered, while 117 cases are active. Nagaland Governor and Chief Minister have greeted Moonkut greeting to Kuki community and to the people of Nagaland. In a message, Ravi said, "Moonkut is a harvest festival, particularly the maize crop, and it is also a period to remember the loss of our loved ones." Saying that love and brotherhood are important essence of this festival, Ravi said, "The Kuki community exhibits their magnificent traditions and customs, wherein the young people familiarize themselves with their roots." Extending greetings, Chief Minister Nipirio hoped that the harvest festival will foster peace, unity, and be a harbinger of blessed beginnings in the lives of everyone. And as the nation fights COVID-19 pandemic, let us all remember to stay safe and protected by following these three simple steps. Wear a face mask, wash hands frequently with soap and water, or use hand sanitizer, and follow social distancing norms. And now, 20 News, here the main points again. Prime Minister Narendra Modi launches world's largest COVID-19 vaccination drive in the country. Chief Minister Nipirio launches state-level program of COVID-19 vaccination at Naga Hospital Authority, Kohima. NBCC General Secretary Reverend Zelho Geho expresses confidence that COVID-19 vaccine will bring protection to the community. And Centre notifies 3,566 posts in central government suitable for persons with disabilities. That is all we have in this evening news bulletin. Good night.